Yo, we are live once again, Thursday Night Live with your boy Floyd. I'm glad to see everybody in the building. We've got 1,000 people right now in the building. Anticipation of this Valentine's sneaker live. Shout out to each and every one of you guys. I appreciate you guys. Shout out to my pops. Shout out to my mom. Definitely always tuning in. Always appreciate their support. And all my friends, family members that tune in every Thursday, I appreciate you guys. So welcome, my friends. Welcome to my sneaker collection factory. I appreciate you guys viewing in once again on a Thursday, spending some time with me, your evening time away from whether your friends or family, whoever it may be, but I appreciate you guys. All the fellas, I appreciate you guys. All the ladies, I definitely appreciate you guys showing up, listening to my lives, you know, every Thursday. I appreciate you guys always showing up. So whoever's in, all the 1,000 are in the building, drop a comment. Let me know that you guys are in here. Let me know who's in here so I can give you guys a shout out. But like I said, I hope you guys are having a great Thursday. One more day for Friday, or actually a few hours before Friday. So thank God for that. I appreciate Thursdays, because I know we're just one more day from the weekend. So that's always nice, a little break from work. So I appreciate each and every one of you guys, each and every 1,000 people that are in this live. I appreciate you guys. So shout out to you guys. I always enjoy seeing people in here, especially on this special live. It's the Valentine's Day sneaker live. I will be showing you 5 of my shoes from my collection. It was hard to pick 5 of them, but basically either Valentine's inspired or Valentine's colors. So very few and far between nice Valentine's sneakers out there, but I did pull, like I said, 5 from my collection. So I'm glad to show you guys those, and hopefully you guys are either impressed or either want to go out and buy those shoes. So I believe they are all Nikes. So, you know, you guys have your treat, especially all those SB heads are in the building tonight. You guys are definitely going to be in a treat for this one. So I'm glad that you guys are tuning in. Let's see who we got. Theo is always in the building. I appreciate Theo from the East Coast, 3 minutes ahead from the West over here. So I appreciate him showing up. He says, yo, sup, Floyd. What's up, Theo? I hope you're having a good Thursday, man. And we got Rocky in the building. Just 2 of the 999 that are in the building right now. So shout out to you too. I appreciate you guys. So Rocky, I always appreciate you showing up. So thank you for that. But before we get into the 5 sneakers, we'll be going into the segment shortly of these, what I would like to call Floyd's pickup. So we'll be going into that shortly, which I am very excited about. Very excited. You guys probably don't see me too excited about certain things, but these pickups, or actually one of these pickups, I'm very excited for. I had it for about a week now. I got it on eBay, and it's not sneaker related. So that's what's really surprising. I'm getting on this little kick right now, and you will see what kind of kick that I'm about to get into. But I'm starting to really fall in love with these particular items, accessories. So I will be showing you this. I spent a good amount of money on it. So I'm happy and I'm excited to see it. And you'll see how my reaction is when I actually have it in hand and when I see it for the first time. I've seen tons of videos on it. I just really fell in love and I knew I had to have it. I just want to give a couple shout outs before I go into Floyd's pickups, but give a huge shout out to eBay name, All Day Lego. So it'd be ALL-DAY-LEGO, LEGO. Shout out to him for hooking your boy up. Well, not technically hooking me up, but he did have this item in hand brand new, because your boy loves to buy things brand new. But his real name is Ramzel, out of New Jersey. So shout out to New Jersey. Shout out to the East Coast out there. I will be showing the item that I purchased, which is this one that I'm extremely happy about. And also shout out to G-Shock is another YouTuber, a huge platform in terms of G-Shock. Shout out to him. Definitely putting me on game in terms of G-Shocks and so forth. So shout out to him. I appreciate all the knowledge he drops in his videos. And if you're not subscribed to him, go check him out. Always picking up the greatest great heat when it comes to G-Shock. So very informative. Also, as far as legit checking, because they do make fakes when it comes to G-Shock. So go to his videos, check him out. If you guys are not subscribed to him, definitely subscribe to him. He's definitely a real good guy. So shout out to him. Also, AKA Chavo, G-Shock Go. So shout out to him. Go check out his video. So let's see. We got JJ, one of the thousand in attendance today. He says, what's good, bro? What's up, Jay? I'm glad to see you in the building. So let's go ahead and go into the segment of Floyd's pickup. So this first one, it's not really a big thing, but as you can see, and if you guys are not familiar with this packaging, you will see that it's once again another Lulu product. Just something light I found. I really like the color. And if you guys are not aware, your boy did create an Instagram. I'm sure you guys are all aware by now. But I will be definitely showing this on there and seeing how I wanted to how I want to style it. But basically, this is a short sleeve tee. Nothing special, just another solid color. But like I said, you cannot go wrong with solid tees, especially nice, comfortable solid tees. And I believe this is called Silver Drop or something like that. But yeah, it's a great tee. If you guys want to go on Instagram, give me a follow there, and also you'll see what shoes I will be styling along with what denim that I'll be styling with. But it's been nice out here in California. It is supposed to be getting colder, but it's been nice, windy. I love the wind. So I'm really happy about that. I mean, I'm sure it causes a lot of people problems, but as far as just the sound of it, the feel of it, it makes me relax. So, like I said, that's the weather that we've been having out here in California. I'm sure it's still cold out there in the East. I know definitely in the Midwest. So, I know you guys are still dealing with that cold weather, but you know, can't beat Cali weather right now, but it is going to get colder, next week. So, really quick before I forget, your boy is rocking the Lulu long sleeve tee. In case you guys don't know, these are fundamentals. Like I said, another just great all around tees. Can rock them, you know, whether to the gym, if you want to go that high end, or if you want to go rock them around, whether you're going out or whether you are going out to the store, just definitely comfortable wear. This is not a license or not a promotion for Lulu, but hey, Lulu, if you guys ever want to promote or sponsor your boy, definitely hit me up in my DMs on Instagram. You can follow me at Floyd Chavez Jr. I will be there. Or you can even hit me up in the DMs on here, or on the messengers on here. Appreciate you. Like I said, I will comment to all your guys's because I do not get a lot of comments. So go ahead and drop me a comment there, whether it's words of encouragement or just saying what's up. So I appreciate you. But yes, I am rocking. It's like a reddish orange, and then you got that black denim. And then I also got this G-Shock, but you guys will see that maybe on one of the later lives. I will definitely show this because it's something very worthwhile showing. So, like I said, I appreciate each and every one of you guys in the building. Now let's get on to this. I'm very happy and excited. Like I said, shout out to All Day Lego on eBay. Picked this up from him, probably from his collection. A very older model. This accessory, I should say, makes me very excited and happy. I will be checking this out just to make sure I have to authenticate it once I get it in hand. But yeah, definitely a great pickup. Very excited. Let me just try to open this because this, like I said, this is all this stuff that I do show you guys on my pickups for the week are stuff that are brand new. As far as like, I've never seen them. I'm not like opening up and retaping them. I'm not doing any of that. So these are all just basically stuff that I'm seeing for the first time. Just like you guys maybe as well. Shout out to him. Definitely use that bubble wrap. I appreciate that. Also, very nice packaging. Like I said, once I'm done authenticating this, just like I do everything I get, I will be sending you positive feedback. I let him know. So getting this started, this definitely reminds me of this song. When I first saw this this watch, I just put this song in my head. So we'll get this playing in the background. Probably get copyrighted, but hey, no one, I don't have that many subscribers, so it's okay. And plus, I won't let it be playing too much. But let's get it going. So check this out. Boom, you got the G-Shock right there. Eminem signature on it. Always G-Shock has those great cases. Got that Detroit skyline right there. Check this out. I'm very, very excited. Also comes in another nice little case. Very luxurious. Got that G-Shock Eminem signature on it. There we go. G-Shock with the E right there. Check this out. Oh yeah. Looks nice. You got that nice pillow with Eminem signature on it. And there we go. Brand new. Just got the plastic on the E. Got that skyline right there. Boom. With the E in the front. And you stand up. Get that little facelift right there. So let's have us a little match. And if anyone asks, it ain't no one but us trash. You don't know, you better act somebody. Cause we're having a white trash party. White trash. Pull up at the Bacardi from out of my underwear. And walk around the party without a care. Like a definitely nice. Cannot wait until I can put this on the wrist. The materials are amazing. Very soft. Just like pretty much all G-Sharks. This is a, in case you guys don't know, this is a 6900. I believe it's the larger style model on of the 6900s, but very nice, very clean, very excited. And like I said, this was not cheap. This was not cheap at all. So just very happy to add this to the collection of G-Shocks. I'm just starting to get into collecting G-Shocks because, you know, sneakers hasn't been really been going to anywhere too crazy right now, so it's a little bit of downtime. I could use the time to pick up some older stuff, but right now I'm just kind of on this kick right now. But don't worry, your boy hasn't lost faith as far as sneakers go. But yeah, I'm just taking a little break from that right now just to purchase some of these old collectibles as far as G-Shock goes. But I'll be getting back into kicks. But like I said, I seen this and I really wanted it for a few weeks now, and I was just able to find a brand new one that's fully complete with box. So like I said, very happy. Thank you. I will be authenticating it, but basically on what I saw right now, it looks like it's pretty good. It looks like it's 100% authentic, but like I said, I'm going to have to go a little bit more into it to make sure. But shout out to my boy All Day Lego from eBay. I appreciate you. I appreciate the sale. The price was a little high, but like I said, you have to pay for things that you definitely want in life. So that's what I did. Marcus, my boy, Marcus Sams is in the building. He says, what's Big Floyd? What's up? What's up, Marcus? I'm glad to see you in here. It's always good to see my boys. One of the thousands that are in attendance tonight. So I appreciate you guys. I know you guys are all in anticipation as far as sneakers go. See, maybe some of these you guys have in your collection, maybe you guys don't, I don't know. But definitely let me know in the comments if you guys have these in your collection, or let me know what Valentine's kicks are in your collection. Whether are they strictly Valentine's themes or they are just Valentine colorways. And then let me know what your guys's five are in your collection as well, as far as what would you guys be rocking this Valentine's Day. I'm not saying if you guys would go out on Valentine's Day in these, because I'm sure if you guys are taking out the ladies out, you definitely have to be dressing up. wearing those boots, those Stacy Adams. So, but I appreciate you guys. And like I said, even the ladies, let me know what you guys, ladies, that you guys will be wearing, whether if it's any type of Valentine's themes sneakers, especially if Valentine's just around the corner next, this coming Monday, actually, after the Super Bowl. So the ladies are definitely going to get gypped this Valentine's, because no one's going to be going out on Sunday unless you just don't like football. So shout out to all the ladies that are in the building. Shout out to my boy, Ricardo Perez. I appreciate you, man. I saw your DM and I hit you back up. So I appreciate you dropping me those, man. Showing me your kicks. Definitely got to pull up one of these Thursdays and show me what you guys, what you got. So let's go ahead and get into the segment of Valentine's kicks. So definitely, let's take a look. As Willy Wonka would say, are we ready? Yes, good, in we go. So let's go ahead and take a look. If you guys could have that little Willy Wonka song in the background in your head, come with me and we'll see in this world of pure imagination. Let's take a look at these sneakers and let's see if you guys have any of them. So shout out to you guys. I appreciate, like I said, I appreciate each and every one of you guys in the building. But let's go with number 5. As you can see, it is a Jordan. I'm not sure if you guys can tell right off the bat on this one. But let's definitely take a look. I'm going to give you, like I said, I always try to give you a little background in case you guys don't know anything about this sneaker. But this is the Air Jordan Retro 6 Carmine colorway, originally released back in 1991. They returned in 2008 with the countdown package. I did have that shoe, sold it, and followed up again in 2014. And now for the 30th anniversary, released on February 13th. So a day before Valentine's last year, released the 30th anniversary. Retail on these were $200. This 2021 shoe brought back the Nike Air for the first time since 1991, which I will show you guys that. The Jordan 6 arrived at a perfect time, seeing how MJ and the Bulls won their first NBA championship that summer. Some background into the Air Jordan 6 was it was designed by Tinker Hatfield. They featured a visible air unit in the heel, as well as a translucent outsole and a molded back heel tab and a set of lace locks. So in case you guys are not familiar with that, I just want to give you that brief little detail about the Jordan 6, but also Lotus asked on these on StockX. In my size, the 10.5 is $270. Highest bid is $245. And last sale was February 9th, which was not too long ago, 2022, for $268. So they're still just a tad over retail, nothing special. Factory flaws on this shoe. I'm not sure. I don't think when I bought these had factory flaws. I think because a lot of the white midsole was like pinkish because of the red dye. So there's a lot of problems with that. But let's take a look. Just so you guys know, I'm not lying to you. It is a 10.5. Your boy always buys 10.5. Every shoe in my collection is a 10.5 except one. And I can think of that one off the top of my head. And maybe I will be showing that in a later video, but that is one of my very limited heaters that I may have to bust out just to show you that it is in the collection one day. So here you go. You got the Carmine. Very nice looking shoe. Cannot go wrong with that. To me, definitely represents Valentine's Day, because you do got that white and that red hits. Also, you got that Nike Air in the back. That's what I mentioned in my details. And you got that black and red spoiler in the back. But amazing shoe. Still dead stock. As you can see, it's going to be very hard for me to wear these even after a year later because of the sole. If I do have to wear them, I probably will have to get that drip grip, spend money on that, which I don't like to spend on stuff like that. But just because of how white and icy this sole is, like I said. So just a very beautiful shoe. Can't say enough about this. I was very happy to see this come back as far as onto the retro circuit, because like I said, I had the countdown package. I wore that, sold it, because I think that was, I had that in when I was in college. I believe I had to buy a 11 in that one. So that was one of the few times I actually did buy 11 in a shoe, which is really rare. So that was one time, but I did sell that eventually because it just, I just didn't, wasn't feeling it. And plus it was a size 11. So wasn't very happy about that. Ricardo Perez says that's a clean pair. No red stains on the midsoles. Nope. I don't think so. I didn't see any, I don't see any pinkish, which, like I said, this tends to be like all the factory flaws. See if we get a little closer look right here. This would turn pink, because of the red dye, up here would turn pink. I'm sorry. Right here would turn pink. So, no, this one doesn't. This was actually a really good pair. And I was very happy to pick that one up. I did not hit for retail on this one, in case you guys were wondering. I did have to pay resale, but they didn't hit me over the head too much, because this shoe's not really, it's not really in demand. Even when it first came out, it wasn't in demand. So definitely going to leave this out for the Instagram post. So something that you guys definitely want to look out for. I do post every shoe that I put on here on an Instagram photo. So, you guys will be seeing that. Also, if you guys can definitely, try to catch the recap videos. I'm going to start doing those. Just try to see if I could pick up some traction as far as, getting views up, subscribers. They will not be long, probably like maybe 3-4 minutes max. Because I'm just basically going to fly through those shoes, because yeah, there's really not much for me to say on those. So just like I said, just trying to get the view. So I would definitely appreciate you guys if you guys could pull through on those recap live videos and just show your boy some love. Give me the views there. Drop that thumbs up. Hit the reminder. Throw a comment. All that. Really appreciate it. And like I said, I'll definitely try to answer any of the comments that you have. Dirty has the heart. Only my left shoe has pink. So yeah, so I didn't check out the other shoe. Maybe it is. I'm not sure. I don't care. I probably won't even wear it anyway. So just probably just stay in the collection. So but that shoe is nice and white. So I'm glad one of them is. So shout out to Dirty. One of the men is starting to make videos again. So I'm very happy. Starting to go on lives. I'm very happy to see him back in the game. Shout out to Dirty. Appreciate you. Shout out to each and every one of you guys that are in the building right now. Jay Hernandez, always dropping videos, but hasn't dropped one in a minute. But shout out to Jay. I know he's just probably around the corner about to make one soon. So let's go on to, so that was number 5. Let's go on to number 4. In case you guys don't know what this box represents right here, people that do have this shoe, I'm sure you guys do. These are the Nike Air Max 90 Bacons. So a little background on this one. This was originally released in 2004, which I did have, and I sold that. It was re-released on Air Max Day for the model's 30th anniversary on March 26, 2021, for a retail price of $140. So not bad, very reasonable price for an Air Max. This shoe was released in collaboration with now closed NYC sneaker boutique Dave's Quality Meat, designed to resemble shades of a strip of bacon. The shoe features shades of red, pink, and sail, constructed with a leather and suede upper. This is widely regarded as one of the most iconic Air Max 90s ever. So very, very limited shoe when it first released in 2004. Was extremely hard to find even to present day, up until the retro. But like when it retroed, there's a lot of people excited for it, but they probably made a whole bunch. So it kind of just brought down the excitement. You know, the resale price is very low. So lowest ask on StockX is 182. Highest bid is 166. That is, like I said, in a 10.5. And then the last sale was February 8th, 2022, for $180. So not very, I think if you guys want a nice shoe, especially in those in these this type of colorway, it's definitely a time to jump on it because the resale is very cheap. So this is one of the shoes that I feel like screams Valentine's just due to the colors. Let's take a look. One of my favorite shoes. Very happy that it came out in a retro. That was the only reason why I sold my original pair, because I knew the price was going to drop extremely low when it came, when this shoe did drop, when it got released to the masses. So let's take a look. Let's see what this is all about. There you go. Boom. Right there. You got those bacon resemblance of the slices, but very great remake, a very great retro of this shoe. When I had the original in hand, I did not have the retro, but from what I remember, it wasn't too far off. The resemblance was there. There was no really big type of differentiation from the shoe as far as original and the retro goes. So just a great, I mean, this is just a beautiful shoe. Like I said, though, if you guys don't have this, you guys should definitely pick this up now, or if you guys want multiple pairs, now's a good time to pick it up because, I mean, the market's low on these. I'm not sure if it was ever high. I actually hit on two pairs, or I actually hit on one pair. They did a shock drop on it, and I hit on that pair thinking that these were selling at a high, but they weren't, so I had to hurry up and sell the one that I did have and wait for that shock drop pair to come to me. So I had to definitely unload it, but nice sneaker. I mean, I didn't need multiple pairs. I just needed one. Like this one, still dead stock, but let's give it a little closer look. So you guys take a look in case you guys don't have this in your collection, or if you guys are deciding if you guys want it. Another great pair, another great Valentine's shoe to definitely go with the whole Valentine's themes as far as colorways go. So great two pair of shoes right there. So if you guys are in the market for any of these pairs, I think now's the time to pick any those two pairs up because you can't beat that price right now. So let's go on now. So let's go on to three. This is definitely a great looking shoe. Cannot say enough good things about it. And let's go into the background of this shoe. So this is the Air Max 97 CR7 Patchwork, aka Portugal. This was released on April 24, 2018. For a retail price of $170. This shoe is Nike collaborating with Cristiano Ronaldo. This masterpiece features a patchwork aesthetic detailing the story of CR7's mother's patching his shoes back together when he was younger to keep him going on the soccer pitch, which helped him drive into becoming one of the greatest footballers of all time. Much like the last offering, Nike replaces the 97 on the heel with the CR7, which I will show you guys. So it reads Air Max CR7, another homage to the world-renowned superstar's nickname. There is also a green and yellow aglets that are accompanied by multi-lace options to complete the look. I have not seen this shoe in a while, but I'm just excited to see it when I first got it because when I was doing the research on this shoe, seeing the photos and how bright the shoe is, it's a very beautiful red, vibrant shoe. The lowest ask on these is $435. Highest bid is $221. And the last sale was February 1st, 2022, which was for a really steal price, $250. I'm very interested to see if that was actually an authentic pair or if that was a fake pair, because that is really cheap for this shoe to be going for. So let's take a look. It did come in that black box, that typical Air Max, also a foamposite box, but black all around. size 10.5. Let's take a look. Let's see this because I haven't seen this in a while. This was purchased on StockX. Back when StockX gave us those little receipts. But here we go right there. Boom, right there. Beautiful. Beautiful, as you can see right there. Let's get a little closer look. Got that patchwork right here. Got some patent leather, different materials with the patchwork. Got that Portugal aglets with the green and yellow hits. Got that red bubble. As you can see, I have not worn these in a long time. So you see the bubble fogging up, which 97s typically do. But I did wear this once or twice. I actually have to give a shout out to one of my friends, Sal Moreno. He's the one that actually told me about this shoe. I wasn't interested when I first saw this shoe. I just kind of overlooked it. I just thought it was an all red shoe. Didn't really pay much attention, but he actually told me that, like, yo, Floyd, you need to take a look at this shoe that's going to be based off a CR7. It's something that you probably would want to get. So then I did my research, I read about it, and I saw that the story behind, you know, the patchwork, his mom, you know, patching up his shoe. And then I really started looking into the details of this 97. And then that's when I realized I needed this shoe in my collection. So, great shoe. I definitely got to get this out more. But I mean, another shoe that I would say screams Valentine's, even though it's really Portugal based, but the colors, I mean, you just can't beat it. Like, look at how beautiful that is as far as the patent leather. You got the different hits of materials. There you go. You got that Air Max CR7, like I said in my details. Great, great looking shoe right there. So shout out to Cristiano Ronaldo on this one, especially for him delivering. I mean, this is just a beauty. This is a beauty right here. I forgot how beautiful it was, especially in hand. Very happy to have this in the sneaker factory collection. So I'm very happy to have that one. I don't have very many 97s. I believe I did feature a 97 not too long ago in my, I want to say, my Christmas video. So go back and check out that one. But I believe those are the only 97s that I have in my collection. So not too many in the collection, but definitely a lot of heaters when it comes to the 97 in the collection that I can always go to. So shout out to that one. So that was my number three. Like I said, before I get into these last two, shout out to all the people that are in this live. I appreciate you guys showing up, showing your boy love. I really appreciate that. It means a lot to me as far as, you know, shoes goes, and just allowing you guys giving me that time to speak to you guys and showing you what I have in my collection. So I appreciate it. So let's get into the last two. The last two are definitely huge shoes in the SB world. Definitely wanted to show these out because I have not showed these. I haven't showed actually any of these in the live. I think the Bacon's only featured in my 22 unboxing shoe and video, but I have not brought that one out in any other live. So I'm trying to bring a mixture of shoes when I do these live for you guys. So at least you guys can know that your boys are just not showing the same stuff over and over. But like I said, shout out to all the fellas in the house, and then definitely all the ladies in the house. I appreciate each and every one of you guys. And if you guys are catching this on the playback, go ahead and hit that reminder so it can remind you that I do these whenever I drop a video, and then also the lives. And also hit that thumbs up. And definitely, if you are not subscribed, definitely subscribe to me. I appreciate it. So let's go on to number four, but I'm going to say number two because I'm going down the list. So this is my number two shoe. Let's read a little bit about this number two shoe. This is the Nike Dunk SB collab with Stussy. This is also known as Cherry, also known as Neapolitan, released in July of 2005. So this shoe was released a long time ago. Retail, this is what trips me out all the time. $65. Amazing quality. Now we pay what, $20 more more, $15 more more, or something like that. Well, actually way more than that, like $40 more on SBs and get cheaper quality. But I don't want to get into that. This was a part of the Nike SB's team manager series, in which the industry team managers were given the opportunity to design their own shoes. The colorway was put together by Robbie Jeffers of Stussy, who took inspiration from the Neapolitan ice cream cone. The uppers are soft chocolate and strawberry colored leather, which the swoosh is a creamy vanilla. The sneaker is finished with a waffle cone insole and a cherry on the tongue. So if you guys are not familiar with these are definitely, you guys are definitely in for a treat. These are also Ricardo Perez's favorite SB, so fire. This is a pair that's still dead stock. Oh, let me see. Let me show you this really quick so you guys know that your boy is not showing fake shoes. But as you can see, got that nice label, 10.5. Still got that 65 label on there. And if you could see it, it says pink/vanilla. I couldn't see that last one. Shy pink/vanilla on there. Here we go. Dead stock. Never been laced up. Your boy never wanted to lace these up because he knew better. But here you go. Let's take a good look at these. Beautiful masterpiece right here. Got that cherry on top. You got that waffle cone inside, like I said in the details. But let's get a little closer so you guys can see that pink suede, chocolate leather, vanilla swoosh. Lovely. Absolutely lovely. A masterpiece. Got that fatty tongue. SB used to do. SB no longer does. I mean, there's just really not much you could say about these. I love this shoe. Very happy to still have this in my collection. Never got rid of it. Never wore it. Classic SB. You cannot go wrong with that one. Let's take a look at the other one, because I want to show you guys a really quick thing on this. Is that, check it out. So my thing was, whenever I bought an SB back then, lace bag still always had to be attached. Lace bag still attached. You got that nice Nike SB plastic zippy that all the shoes used to come with as far as SB goes. Pink lace is still inside, still attached, still going strong, because your boy knows how to take care of his shoes. Literally, these shoes just sit in the closet and don't get any sunlight until now. Haven't brought these out in a minute. But great shoe. Let's see what these are going for on StockX. I'm just curious. I want to show you guys what they're going for on StockX. So StockX lowest ask in a 10.5 is $3,992. Highest bid is $1,949. And last sale was September 16th, 2021 for $3,790. So you see what your boy is rocking with. You see what your boy has in his collection. At any given time, I can definitely come out with that shoe. That shoe is going to stay in there until I'm ready to take the photo, because I do not want that shoe to be exposed to light up until now. So I'm not going to put that one out. But drop a comment. Let me know. I know all the sneakerheads know what's up with that shoe. Theo, if you're still in the building, man, let me know if you have that shoe in your collection. I would love to know. 2005 pink box, definitely the top tier of SBs. I want to say set just right below silver box, because I love the silver box era, the golden age of SBs. But the pink box is just literally scraping the bottom of that silver box. So let me know if anybody besides Ricardo, because he showed me a picture a little earlier before I dropped this live, that he did have those. So shout out to Ricardo. Ricardo, are yours still dead stock or did you actually wear yours? Let me know in the comments. But definitely let me know in the comments. Those are the four so far from my Valentine's theme sneakers. Like I said, it was very hard to slim these down to five. I had a lot that I could have brought out, but I just wanted to, I felt like these ones represented Valentine's extremely well as far as, you know, the colorways go, the limitedness of this, of some of these shoes, not all of these shoes, but a lot of the colors were very, very Valentine's themed. So, something I definitely wanted to show you guys, as far as pink boxes go, that I do have a large range of pink boxes in the collections. And that's just the tip of the iceberg when it comes to pink boxes. Ricardo says, DS lace bag still attached. 10 and a half. My boy is the same size as me. So shout out to Ricardo. Way to keep those on ice. Just a very hard shoe to wear. I actually had the matching shirt to go with that shoe because I did want to eventually wear it a long time ago. I never got around to wear it. I still kept the shirt in bag. If you guys want to take a look at that shirt, look at my Instagram. It is on there with along with the shoes right beside it. But the shirt was a vanilla colorway. Had the ice cream cone with the chocolate, strawberry, and vanilla, and it had Nike SB slightly on one of the scoops of the ice cream. So just a great looking shoe. So we are 42 minutes and 5 seconds and counting into the video, and we're getting onto number five, which is really number one in my Valentine's arsenal as far as shoes go. This one I had to put as my number one. I just had to, because the theme, it represents Valentine's, the whole theme of the sneakers. So if you guys are not aware, this did come in this teal box, but I know some of them came in the rainbow color boxes. I don't know why some came in that box, others came in this box. I don't know if those came along with the special edition boxing. I don't know. But if you guys do know, let me know in the comments. But this is the Nike Dunk SB Strange Love. This was released on February 1st, 2020. The Strange Love website, which came in a special packaging, released these on February 1st. But as far as sneaker shops go, these were released on February 7th, 2020. And then also on the Sneakers app, which I did not have any luck on. Released on the day after, which is February 8th. So these released right around Valentine's, perfect timing because of the colorway. The retail on these were only $100, which is crazy. I did not get these for retail. I paid the aftermarket price on these. But keynote, Sean Cliver is the founder of Strange Love skateboarding brand. This is a Valentine's collaboration. These are heavily focused on quality materialization as they arrive engineered with a blend of premium velvet and a suede textures, painted in a holiday appropriate red / pink hues, filled with the elements mirroring that of the brand's love struck characteristics. This rendition is decorated with skull face heart embroideries on the rear laterals, the imprint's name on the tongue, and the insole graphics split between skeletal cupids and a skateboarder intertwined with a ribbon rose. Furthermore, the outsoles also usher in harp-shaped confetti placed on the forefoot and on the heel regions. StockX lowest ask is $1,174. Highest bid is $1,020, and last sale was February 8th, 2022 for $1,100. So I did not pay in the thousands for this shoe. I paid close like mid hundreds on this, so I did not get hit over the head. I had perfect timing on these. So before I can get into these though, let's make sure your boy is not lying to you. Size 10 and a half. Let's try to get a closer look. Nike SB Dunk Low Pro QS. Let's take a look. My number one Valentine shoe in the collection. Just a beauty. Probably will never wear this shoe, but come Valentine's Day, you will see an Instagram photo with these. But there you go. You got the Strange Love, all velvet, right here. And then you also have this nice buttery suede. When they made these, they took it back to the silver boxes as far as the suede goes, because this is freaking buttery. Got that skeletal heart. Boom, Stock X, as you can see, because your boy, I did not even know they have a little feather in there. Velvet insoles, velvet tongue. Let's see if I could get a closer look. Strange Love on the tongue. Beautiful shoe right here. And then you got that heart-shaped confetti on the outsole, translucent sole. Wow. I have not pulled these out in so long, but they're just beautiful. I know Jay has them, Jay Hernandez. If he's still in the building, I know he has them, and he actually wore them. Crazy, Jay. Crazy. But that's what Jay does. He wears his shoes, unlike myself. I rarely wear them. Shout out to Jay though for actually putting these on foot, but also when he put them on foot, he did not put the drip grip, he just wore them. So shout out to Jay, he's a crazy man. But yes, number one in my sneaker collection as far as Valentine themed shoes right here. Beautiful shoe, love it, love it, love it. Prices are still extremely high on this, and I really doubt they'll ever drop. I'm putting this one in the box until I actually pull it out for the Instagram photo. But there you go. There's my number five. Five Valentine shoe plus this beautiful Eminem G-Shock. Not the greatest fan of Eminem, but the G-Shock is amazing. And the collaboration between him and G-Shock is amazing. So shout out to every single person in the building. Shout out to all the ladies in the building, all the men in the building. I appreciate you guys for once again showing up for your boy, Thursday Night Live. And like I said, like I end always all the lives, tune in next Thursday, 7:30 Pacific Standard Time, 9:30 Central Time, and 10:30 Eastern Time. Your boy will be coming out with more shoes. I already know what I'm going to be delivering you guys come next week. I already have it in mind as far as the shoes go, as which ones I will be pulling from the Sneaker Factory collection. I don't know yet because I have a ton of them, but I know what model I'm going with. So tune in for that next Thursday. Hope to see you guys, each and every one of you guys in here. As we always go towards the end of the segment, you know your boy is going to do his checkout time straight out of Tupac, All Eyes on Me album, book two, I believe that song is called, and then also Picture Me Rolling. So let's do the Picture Me Rolling shout out call. All the people, all the thousands that were in attendance today. Nike SB, Theo was in the building, Rocky was in the building, Marcus was in the building, Jay Hernandez always in the building, Ricardo Perez, my boy, always showing up. Dirty made a great appearance in the live. I appreciate each and every one of you guys. Like I said, if you guys are catching this on a playback, give your boy some love. Drop a thumbs up. Drop a reminder to remind yourself, don't forget about me. Also, drop that subscription or that sub. If you guys are not subscribed to me, we got G Perez. Sometimes late, but always on time. Always coming through the live. My boy. That's a Valentine's Day list right there. That's what he says. I appreciate G. I know he probably has these SBs beat to death in his collection because that's what Jay does. That's what G does. He definitely wears his shoes. Shout out to G. I appreciate you showing up, man. I appreciate you always showing love. But that was the we got to go because it's about that time. It's checkout time. Your boy got to get out of here. And like I said, the front desk is calling. They're calling me to check out. So I'm going about to check out right now. But like I said, I appreciate you guys. Don't forget, catch next Thursday Night Live with your boy Floyd. Also catch the recap of these. I will be dropping a video, a recap, just going over these really quick in case people do have forgotten or never checked in. Sarah Angeles, can you put some sticky glue into your mouth to talk? Shout out to Cher. I appreciate you. Thank you for the view. Thank you so much. I appreciate each and every one of you guys. But thank you once again for showing up like you guys always do. I appreciate you guys. Have a great week. Have a great weekend. Enjoy the Super Bowl. I'm looking forward to the Bengals win. So hope you guys are as well. So have a good one. I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for all the views. Thank you.